The scale of the raids is unprecedented. In more than 40 cities across Russia, offices linked to the country's main opposition figure, Alexei Navalny, were searched and employees detained, like here in St. Petersburg. In Yekaterinburg, documents and a USB drive were confiscated.
My daughter called me and said the police came to search the apartment. Actually, they cheated their way into the apartment because she opened the door for a neighbor.
To Navalny, it is clear the raids are President Putin's revenge for the loss of the ruling party in Sunday's elections.
This time he got really upset because of the tactical voting. As his offspring, his sweet child, I would say, the United Russia Party has been busted in Moscow and seriously beaten in the regions.
After opposition candidates were banned from running in the elections, tens of thousands took to the streets in the largest protests in Russia in years. When the ban remained in place, Navalny called for a so-called smart vote against United Russia. His strategy worked in Moscow, where the ruling party lost one-third of its seats, mainly to the Communist Party. For years, Alexei Navalny has been the subject of investigations and detentions. The most vocal critic of Vladimir Putin has spent hundreds of days in prison in the past 8 years. But never before he managed to hit United Russia and indirectly Putin as hard as last Sunday. Navalny says he won't give up, but looking at the raids today, he could be facing some difficult times ahead. Stepfasen, Al Jazeera, Moscow.